Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau faces uproar from Conservatives in Parliament after he invoked emergency powers to stop COVID-19 protests. A trucker-led movement calling on the government to lift vaccine mandates and other restrictions has occupied parts of downtown Ottawa since late January. It had also blocked a major U.S. border crossing, but it was cleared over this weekend. Now, Trudeau said he acted after seeing that law enforcement could not cope with the protesters, especially on Ottawa.
I want to be very clear, Mr. Speaker. The scope of these measures are time-limited and geographically targeted. They are reasonable and proportionate to the threats they are meant to address, and they are fully to be compliant with the Charter of Rights and Freedoms to reassure all Canadians that this is the right thing to move forward with.
Isn't it true that the Prime Minister's actions could serve to actually make things worse and not make things better?
Mr. Speaker, this is about keeping Canadians safe, protecting their communities and neighbourhoods, and ensuring the jobs and our economy.
Trudeau is only the second Canadian leader to invoke the Emergencies Act in peacetime. The law gives authorities broad powers, including the ability to cut off protesters' funding and reinforce provincial and local law enforcement with federal police. The World Bank warns the global economic recovery may be at risk of financial fragility, citing the rise in bad debt as one of its reasons. In its 2022 development report, the World Bank said developing countries are more at risk, naming the Philippines as an example of a country where bad debt is becoming a problem. The World Bank adds the economic crisis of inflation and higher interest rates may spread rapidly due to financial fragility.
Private debt is at a record high and credit conditions are tightening. A growing share of businesses are expecting to fall into arrears. A new wave of loan defaults would lead banks to tighten their lending standards. This is pro-cyclical, deepening the downturn. It worsens inequality, typically hitting low-income households and small businesses the hardest. And second, sovereign debt has also spiked during the pandemic. It's reached new highs for some governments as revenues plummeted and related COVID-19 expenditures soared. As monetary policy tightens in the advanced economies, debt servicing and rollovers will become a greater burden. It's critical that risks be uncovered and managed early. The alternative, protracted debt crises and restructurings, risks derailing growth and development for years.
Employees in Belgium may now work for only 4 days a week. The government unveiled the new policy in a bid to bring flexibility to an otherwise rigid labor market. Employees requested will be able to work for up to 10 hours a day if trade unions agree, instead of the maximum 8 hours in order to work done one day less per week for the same pay. Belgians will also be able to choose to work more during 1 week and less the following one, allowing them better management of their work and private life. The agreement also introduces the right to disconnect after normal working hours for companies with more than 20 employees and sets out new rules for so-called platform workers like Uber drivers. Belgium aims at an 80% employment rate for 2030.